Hello, cinephiles. Today I'm going to be doing a look inspired by Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind, a movie directed by Michel Gondry. This movie stars Jim Carrey and Kate Winslet as Joel and Clementine, you know, a couple that falls in and out and back in love as the story runs its course. The alternate universe where it all takes place in features a company, firm, by the name of Lacuna Incorporated, where people can go to have their painful past memories erased. After a particularly scathing fight between the two of them, Clementine hires Lacuna to erase her memories of Joel, and he, upon hearing of this, you know, follows suit. In the end, however, all seems hopeful as Joel and Clementine's paths once again intersect and their love takes root for a second time, even though they don't remember who each other is. As a whole, the film goes through scenes of melancholy, whimsy, romance, panic. It's an extremely emotional roller coaster, to be honest. I tried to portray this diversity in my look today. Okay, so this is the final look. Stay tuned so you can see the process of how I made my face look like this, and maybe you'll learn something about the movie on the way. Who knows? Change your heart. As you can see here, I am wearing a blank face. I've just done my cover-up and my eyebrows. Anything really works for this, so just do your regular routine. I'm using my Maybelline Rock Nudes palette with the matte black on the far bottom row. And I'm going to be putting this in my crease. I'm using this to signify the mise-en-scene of the opening scene of Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind. In that scene, you often see a lot of blues, blacks, grays. This signifies Joel's darkened, depressed attitude. It's a common thread throughout the movie that he has these hues related to him. And I'm going to blend that out. Next, I am taking the light matte white on the top row and putting it on my brow bone. This is meant to exemplify the backlighting used so often in Gondry shots, making those colors pop. Next, I'm taking that sparkly blue from the top row and applying it to my lid, exemplifying that blue hue from Joel's color story. Once again with that white, I'm going to take that and add that to the inner corner. This adds a sort of brightness to the darkness. And I'm also going to be taking my NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk and putting that on my waterline. My L'Oreal liner, I'm going to be doing my eyeliner sharp and at a cat eye point. This is to symbolize Gondry's love of sharp, startling shots. My Rimmel Scandalized Retro Glam mascara, I'm doing my lashes to signify Clementine's love for vintage and retro items. This is the final eye look. It's heavily influenced by this shot from the film. Next, I'm going to take my Estee Lauder Melon Lipstick. It's kind of an ode to Clementine's orange hair in the film, her Agent Orange hair. I was thinking about doing a nude lip for her, as she doesn't wear much makeup, but of course I had to do a fun color with all that gloomy mise-en-scene-inspired stuff going on the eyes. And this is the final look. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope you'll come back for more.